Hello, welcome back to Movies with Raymond. Today's movie is the 2004 movie musical, The Phantom of the Opera, starring Gerard Butler, Emil Rossum, and Patrick Wilson. Before we discuss the movie, let's look at the clip.
Lot 666, a chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera. Gentlemen.
Wasn't that a good clip? I thought so. Now there's been many versions of Phantom of the Opera. There's been horror versions, there's been dramatic versions, and there's been the most well-known version, the Broadway version. Now this movie musical is based off of the Broadway version. Now, this was originally made by Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber for his then-wife, Sarah Brightman. One day, when he was looking for a project for Sarah to do, he was walking along in a French bookstore, and he picked up a book by an author named Gaston Leroux, and he read it, and that book became the Phantom of the Opera. As I said, there's been many different versions of the Phantom of the Opera. And my favorite version is the 1989 Robert Englund version, which, of course, a story of Robert Englund is a horror version. I know what you're thinking to yourself. Wait. Isn't Robert Englund Freddy Krueger? And what's he doing in a Phantom of the Opera? Well, as I've said to you, not all Phantom of the Operas have to be the same. And If you want something cool to watch, watch the 1989 version of the Phantom of the Opera, and we're gonna discuss that later. Now, in my list of favorite Phantoms, since I've watched them all, I would say the Broadway version is my favorite, the horror version is my second favorite, and this one is my third favorite. Because I'm kind of a Phantom nerd, and they changed some of the words and the structure of the story to make a better movie. But nobody else would notice that except me. I'm a Phantom nerd, as I said. Now there's a lot of good songs in the Phantom, and I'm going to show you one of my favorites. Although I can sing the whole score basically, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to show you my favorite song.
You were once a friend.
Now, wasn't that a good clip? Or a video, I should say. Well, in case you like me, and you're very picky about these things, and you're saying to yourself, he never explained the story, well, here it is in a nutshell. Both the Phantom and Raoul fall in love with Christine. The Phantom helps Christine with her voice. Raoul is a childhood friend that loved her from the very beginning. The Phantom takes Christine to his underground lair, and Raoul basically has to rescue the damsel in distress. Well, that's the basic story, but me explaining the story to you is not the same as watching the movie. So watch the movie and form your own opinion on the movie. If you like Emma Rossum, as I do, you might like the show Shameless. Because I watch Shameless, and I never realized that was Emma Rossum. I'm going to show you what Emma Rossum looks like in the Phantom and in Shameless, just so you can see how dumb I was that I didn't notice that that was the same person. And here it is. I know what you're thinking. He is stupid. Duh, of course that's the same person. Well, when you're used to seeing her in one thing, and you finally realize that it's her in another thing, it's kind of hard to put the two things together, because in Shameless, she's cursing and yelling, as you saw in the makeup, whatever. And in Phantom, she's all pretty and meek and sings her butt off. Well, as I say in all my movies, if you disagree with anything I say, or you have an idea for next time, let me know on my YouTube wall. You have been watching At the Movies with Raymond. Sorry, I was a little tongue-tied with that one, but whatever.